Not only left all the natural wonders of the earth. How is it? There is no natural chaos. Even though we live on a very living planet, so I left natural violence out. I left violence by nature, acts of the universe, acts of God, or whatever. Left it out, and I just dealt with the human quotient of violence itself. In its many forms, and surprisingly, how it all seemed to me to lead back to media, canned violence, the screen here is 25 minutes, it was 2.5 hours, this screen was an hour, it's now 10 minutes, and I wanted to show the representation that, if you want violence, man, you just walk out the door, it's there. You get three times as much violence as you can find peace. Peace is very, it's not actually, it's not there because it's not something that is in front of things, or there's no path to follow for peace, but peace, it is the way, it is the thing that we're looking forward to. So it's like, I'm trying to show the lesser quantity of peace, because it's more ephemeral than violence. Violence, man, is like,
well, I appreciate the work you put in to just physically make this thing happen. I mean, what you have is pretty simple. But on the other hand, I know that it required a lot. And it's really true to your initial idea. You've really been driven by trying to make that work. I like those aspects of it. At first, I thought maybe it was intentional, but I don't know why it would be. But the reversed images bother me a lot. This text is so important. It may not be important because it's there. We tend to read it, and that's annoying. Maybe that was intentional. I'm guessing it's not. Yeah. But I think you can just flip the projector. I think it's a switch.
I'm great behind a Nikon or Canon 81. You mean a digital camera or technology? To me by the wayside. I was not born with the technology gene, so.
Well, we'll mention that in your vibration, for sure. But I think it was just a strange thing. The other thing is, I'm more compelled by the violent side. And I thought, well, maybe that's me. Or maybe it's a better video. Maybe part of it is that when it comes to drama, the violence tends to be compels us more than the goodness. The goodness tends to not hit us over the head. You know what I mean? It's just more passive. But I also kind of wonder if your footage of what you're trying to represent here is as good as it could be. A lot of it's like talking heads and movies and stuff like that. It doesn't carry the kind of gravity of this side. The little thing you have with the repetition with the De Niro movie, things like that kind of give it a rhythm and kind of almost make it musical, and the sort of pattern is established and we're expecting it to come back again. It draws us.
I would have liked to see like Sound of Music footage or something.
I love the Raging Bull clip in that. I feel like it's sort of it's good to repeat it because it's like a mirror for us. And we're watching this and it's like it's punching us in the face, but we want more. I'm not even looking at the screen. I want to see that screen. I want to see. And I want it to be shocking.
I don't know if the word peace keeps getting to me with this screen, because I've actually been watching the screen a lot. Like, and I'm thinking, like, it's more like just non-violence. Like, the other gamut of human emotion other than violence is what you're expressing in a lot of these shows, because a lot of them are really sweet, like, you know, children connecting, or like just like a woman smiling, or like, you know, a dance thing or something. I'm not sure if like you totally captured the essence of peace. It's more just like the other emotions. And maybe you can like expand on that or something.
Personally, I like that because I think that the concepts of peace are very different from person to person, you know. I mean, I think about like the natural predation, you know, it's a questionable idea of violence. Jeez, you know, I kind of grapple with this along with me too. What is it like eating something else? You know what I mean? Or destroying something else? You know, it happens all throughout nature. It seems like we're just kind of a reflection of the wider circumstances and, you know, just the processes that are life and death. You know, I mean, it's not something that I'm saying that I appreciate seeing some shit get done or something like that. You know, it's just I don't really like understand this. You know what I mean? Necessarily approach that. I just kind of recreate like what is going on all over the place all the time in the future. So,
I had less debt, but my SR reading is more combat for 6 months. Medical. And I've always treated my dad has something to do with that, since he was such a major complaint for the insurance. You know, did a little insurance push break that for, you know. And because my uniform already, so like the first of mine came back, or two of my friends came back, and one to kill you, and was a great close, you know, the wild horse. And, but I always had a guilt thing. And what I guilt thing is back then, I don't have that knowledge. But I'm just saying that I could, you know, I could not from that. I'm not one of them.
So it's definitely something I think about a lot, you know, goes through my head. Is there any way to really avoid violence at all?
No, I don't think so. I think it's part of my nature that it's not really fun. I don't even think it's a negative thing, it's more of a kind of predicated for DNA for survival. Kinds of violence, yes, but when you talk about surviving, it's okay, like, I wanted to show, I had two different ways to go, and I wanted to be a little bit more constructive on the violence, because I still think if you see the whole presentation, which probably won't, I don't know, and again, that just shows flavor, quantity, levels of violence that we're inundated with, but more so, I wanted to show how media is responsible for keeping this totally inundated from generation to generation to generation to generation. It's just like the domino theory, you know. And as a society, it's a global society. It's really hard to break their control on us, you know, by individuals. Well, it has to be done individually, actually, but by the representation of what is of what the almighty images are, it's usually, I work from a research group, national research, and it was like, basically, their target audience were white males from 18 to 35 years old. No one else really didn't have it. That was their audience, and that's where the Nielsen ratings come from, get a lot of money from. Okay? It's sort of like Dow Jones of media presentation in the world. Depends on who gets the money, who, you know, gets into his body, you know, this national research field. And,
Al, I keep hearing you talk about how you're really upset with, like, how these statistics are, and I totally can relate to that, but I'm wondering what your experience as a white male, you're not in that age bracket anymore, but you know what I mean, like, it feels like you're a little bit divorced from the fact that you're talking from this perspective and you're enraged about it, because I'm not, like,
hearing you. Well, I used a lot of years in my like, believing a lot, and that's why kind of goes right back to that, the ghost stuff. You know, why did I have to buy that part, particular part of something. And then as far as the age thing is, I don't feel any issues. It's not even, I just don't. It's not a denial, it's just I don't. For me, it's not a closure.
I wish the, as for the projections, you know, I wish they would have filled up the space a little more so it became like overwhelming or even bleeding off the edges if I wanted to fill up the space. As well as, like, I felt, you know, if you're supposed to be referencing women's genitalia, that these could have been pulled together a little bit more.
Yeah.
And that would have made that reference a little more clear rather than having to tell us that. As well as like having these images where one is very violent, some of them are violent, like I said, but it's some more peaceful images that they would be touching, even or all the more close where they'd be threatening to touch each other or interact, you know. And then if they were bleeding off of the edges, then like they would actually be overlapping and touching.
That was one of the things I talked to Robin about, and she says, no, we're gonna have to. If you want to send some laser, you're going to need wheelchair clearance.
Uh-huh.
And so I had to.
But wheelchair clearance is only 3 feet.
No, on either side.
You could have, brought that together a little more. I do appreciate, like, the building up these walls around it to sort of close off, you know, this room so that we can sort of get in the illusion of having, being in a new space. Also have to be timekeeper and note that we have like 5 minutes.
It is supposed to carry women's genitalia as well as the woman, and being spiritual is sort of like being born in a moment, spiritually birthed from different levels, and kind of coming out into the world again.
Okay, I totally missed that. Okay. Was spacing out or something?
It was in the statement in the entrance.
Yeah,
outside.
It was in the statement, but Eric and I talked about it earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And then Robin and Harrington and I talked about this as well.
That changed everything.
The issue came up, and then I said, okay, so I, you know, the dream has a silver ball. And I just had to deal with it. You got to adapt to it. But it's still basically my own statement, just a my basic aspiration for the dream was to be peace, and whatever came along, kind of adapted to it. But
I think I
relate
your piece pretty
well,
like the audience coming into it.
Interact with the installation.
Yeah.
This was supposed to have been the vault right here, and this is the trap, the trap.
But I think
back on this way into the world.
Yeah, I think that maybe had this been a little more room on this side, we could have entered from both sides. And I don't know. I don't know if we necessarily have to go back in, like, but maybe coming in and out in that exchange.
Creating both of these videos that you think about what scenes we're showing together, like for instance, if you had, you know, Martin Luther King talking on this side, maybe you had a riot from that era going on this side, you know, so you had peace, and then the next scene would be another sort of violent, you know, showing, you know, that it would have collaborated together more, I think, than having two separate videos. I think that would have been a more collaborative effort at the time. Given the time element that we had to do, I would love to do that, to kind of cue in each image.
A simple,
to play off the piece.
Yeah,
simple
way to do it.
Shots were, you had to sit there and look back, and it's like, it was almost cued up.
Yeah.
You know, and you were like seeing someone come out of the military, and you would get synced up and everything. kind of thinking about that a lot while I was watching. I was trying to see if you were doing something with that story.
Okay, you gotta be drunk. Do you have any key questions you want to ask the audience?
Would it affect anybody? You know, I mean, was your quality of imagery? Not the problem, talk about the effect. What are people feeling the effect from watching?
I think I've seen too many faces like that videos that are really shot with this. I guess that's interesting, you know, someone that I've watched stuff like that, but, you know, I don't know, I've seen some pretty violent stuff, and even watching mainstream movies like Saving Private Ryan, where they drop the door and it's blown off, you know, it wasn't really too bad for me, to be honest. I don't know, I was almost expecting a lot more with the state up there.
Last minute thing is that they changed the DVD on me. They gave it to someone else, and I specifically asked for two DVDs. There is, you know, the same kind, because I wanted to loop it, and that was the thing. And I just looked at it. Next one, tell this one. We spent much time talking about.
I think that's
the same.
Yeah.
No, I'm just saying, is that.
Right.
Is this what
we
do?
Right.
I'm
just trying to critique and not the equipment. So I think on the floor, like, you wanted it to tear and deteriorate as we walked over it. Maybe if you had done something, like, the carpet is pretty insular, and so maybe if there had been something else underneath it, like, or if it had been wet, or if there's, like, maybe sandpaper or something that would assist in it tearing.